Do you really need salicylic acid when you have acne? Not sure, girl. Not sure. Hey, look who is here. So, Guabao. Hello, baby. Hello, bonjour, coucou, I hope you are all doing good. Welcome, or welcome back to my channel, my name is Cyril. So I used to be a stem cell researcher for quite some time, and this is why I can tell you about the science behind skincare ingredients. And for today's video, we are not going to talk about my dog, even though I can talk about him like for hours and hours because I love him so much, but we are going to talk about salicylic acid, aka a beautiful BHA, so I'm basically going to give you like the tea in a way about it, and also a controversial opinion about it, if I dare say. So let's dive in, people. So the first thing is, of course, what is the damn salicylic acid? Salicylic acid is an acid in the sand that is going to exfoliate your skin, and it is in the beautiful family of BHA for beta hydroxy acid. What the heck it is. So the BHA family is basically a family of acids that are soluble in lipids. This is something that is very, very important because it is going to impact the function of these acids in terms of exfoliation. So in the skin, we have, I would say, sort of two families of lipids. We have the one that are like really like in the structure of your skin, of your epidermis, of the stratum corneum, aka the skin barrier, like the ceramide, the cholesterol, and the free fatty acid. And those ones are basically in between the dead cells. We have another class of lipids, which are the one that are produced in your sebaceous glands, so aka inside your pores, and the pores are going to ooze this sebum to have like your sort of natural moisturizer in a way. This is important because the BHA is of course going to act at the surface of your skin, but it's also going to be dissolved in all the lipid that you have in your pores, and therefore it is going to exfoliate also the inner part of the pores. So we don't really understand exactly how salicylic acid exfoliate the skin. Most likely what is going to happen is that it's going to disrupt the connection between the dead skins, which are named the desmosome. So they are this is a complex protein that acts like a scratch. Two desmosomes can be linked together, and the salicylic acid is going to break these bonds, hence why we have what we call a keratolytic activity. And on top of that, it also have what we call a comedolytic activity properties, which means that it's going to help to basically declog the pores, which is obviously something that you want. Your pores are clogged from the sebum, but also from all the dead skin cell that has been accumulated with the sebum. So this is why you have a black head. It also could be a white head, which is basically the same thing. The only difference is that the surface of it has not been in contact with Mr. Oxygen. Maybe it is Madame Oxygen, actually. And with the oxidation, it is going to give like this dark spots, basically, which is why you have a black head. Another thing that is very interesting about salicylic acid is that it can decrease the sebum production, but there is a pretty big one. Indeed, from a study where they have compared salicylic acid versus pyruvic acid, which is also an acid that occurs in the cells, they have observed a reduction of sebum production, especially with salicylic acid, but guess the concentration that they use. 50% of salicylic acid. So way above what we what is used actually in all the skincare. In skincare, you basically see salicylic acid at 2% max, and I'm going to talk a little bit more about this at the end of this video. The two last interesting properties is that salicylic acid is also anti-inflammatory, and this is actually possible even with over-the-counter salicylic acid because it has been shown between 0.5% to up to 5%, so this is interesting. And we also know that salicylic acid is antifungal and also antibacterial, so I mean, it makes sense. There is a big, I would say, but about all of this, and this is of course the concentration of salicylic acid. Because if you are going to see a professional, like a doctor that does aesthetics, for example, and anti-aging, or a dermatologist, they can prescribe you like a peeling solution, for example, with a higher concentration in salicylic acid. And in those cases, you will benefit from all that I've talked about, or most of it. However, in over-the-counter skincare, like in a face wash or even in a lotion, most of them are only going to contain up to 2%. percent. Which is why, in my experience, I think this is the main reasons why I've never seen any major difference when people are incorporating only salicylic acid in their routine, especially to treat acne. This being said, I have to say that if you are suffering from acne, of course salicylic acid is one of the gold standard treatment. If you combine it with a good old AHA like glycolic acid, you will see a difference, but on its own, for the mass majority of people, I do not think that you will see like tremendous results. One product that I always recommend is the one from PolarChoice, which is the 2% BHA liquid. I mean, this formula is simply flawless and it is effective, which is also something that is important. On my channel, also on my Instagram account, despite that it is praised by a lot of dermatologists, I do not recommend like wash that contains salicylic acid. I do find them like pretty not useful. I do prefer that you use a peeling solution such as the one from PolarChoice if you really want to have like good results. So basically that's it. Tell me what you have experienced with a good BHA, so salicylic acid. Did you find it like very amazing on your skin or not? I am really interested about this. That's basically it for today. Of course, if you like this video, you know the drill, give it a big thumbs up. If you are new, please consider to subscribe to my channel and don't forget the bell to get notified. Also, I have two Instagram accounts now, one in English, one in French. I have to say that my French is a bit better than my English. So you can check my Instagram accounts. I thank you so much for your time and I will see you next time, beautiful people. Au revoir.